Sunday night's brand new episode of When Calls the Heart, and today Ken's got a DIY to bring some of that Hope Valley decor straight into our homes, man. I love this, Ken.
I know, I'm getting all sort of upset because there's only a few more episodes left. I don't know what I'm going to do. It's a good one, though, coming up because it's Aaron, you know, Elizabeth, Aaron Craighouse's character. She finds herself sort of in the wrong place at the wrong time because of that Lucas, you know, played by Chris McNally with his mysterious past. So I hope everything goes okay for Elizabeth.
Well, my fingers are crossed. But look at him. He looks a little mischievous in that picture.
He does.
Okay,
so. But I love the decor. The thing I love, like, I love the characters, but I just love Hope Valley. You know, it's the beautiful town. It's such a great period in North American, you know, history. It's based in 1910. And you've got sort of all these, like, woods, these natural materials, and everything is very sort of, like function-driven. So it really sort of harkens back. And we may think that 1910 was so long ago, but 1910 was the year that Mark Twain died. We lost Winslow Homer, the artist. But several people, like new people were born. Kitty Carlisle Hart was born in 1910. My grandmother was born in 1910. So a lot of it still has to do with today, which is just, I love it.
If you asked me one thing about 1910, I don't think I could tell you. I mean, like I could now. All right, well, thanks for that history lesson too, Ken. I mean, I'm not surprised at all that we got a history lesson out of this. Okay, but we've got these great
These are milk cans, also known as milk churns. I've got my grandmother's, my mom has it. I've got one in our house in the country. And I love to find a way to like, that's my grandmother's. It's been around since the beginning of time. There you can see on our front deck is one of ours. And so finding a way to incorporate these in today's lives, I want to give everyone at home three ways that they can use them.
Beautiful, let's start with the first one. You're gonna do a little side table, aren't
you? First, we're gonna do a little side table, very easy. What I have here is a plywood round, and what I did was I got a stencil, a big stencil, and then I just found a color that was just slightly off the table color. I went ahead and stenciled it, just to give us a very sort of subtle pattern.
Oh, I see, just a slight bit darker. Look how good that
looks.
Exactly,
and then what I'm gonna do is I have a round here. I'm gonna use this red one.
Okay.
I've got this round, which is just slightly smaller here.
Okay.
All I'm gonna do is, now I'm using hot glue, but if you're doing this at home, I would use wood glue. And you're just gonna pop that right on, right in the center. And what that is going to do, without damaging, because you really don't wanna damage, if you've got a milk can, a vintage one, and great, you don't wanna, that's gonna do that. And having that lid on there, it's gonna keep, if you knock into it, et cetera. As simple as that, voila, we have a nice little side table, indoor, outdoor. Voila.
Just like that. I love that one. The next one.
Oh, yes, a bird bath.
That's right, for the birds.
So now, if you've got one, they also make reproductions. So if you don't have your grandmother's, you can get these at craft stores, et cetera. So then you can leave them outside and not be worried about them. They also are waterproof.
Okay.
For this one, all I'm going to do is do a little hot glue around the edge. And this is a galvanized one. So these really started being used around 1850 to actually transport milk from the dairies to the consumers. And they were used up until the late 70s. 79 was when the last dairy stopped using
them. Is that right? That's a lot later than I would have guessed. And I like how you've got different versions, probably from different eras of these milk.
Right, exactly.
Cans.
So all I've done is use hot glue, or you can use silicone, because you can peel that off and you won't damage the can.
Okay.
I put a tray on here, just a galvanized tray. You do want to make sure that tray is waterproof. Set that out in your garden and purely fill it with water, and you have this sort of wonderful, very of the period bird bath that I think is far more charming than a sort of store-bought one.
I think that is absolutely great. And if you have a Great Dane or a large dog, it could be just like a watering bowl for them too. They could just walk right up to it.
So now some of them, like the one I have, has already been painted a million times. Yeah. So if you've got one already painted, don't worry about painting it again. Just go ahead and do it.
Is this for the flowers?
This is for the flowers.
Oh, okay, I'm gonna put this guy over here then.
What I did was I went ahead and I spray painted this a navy blue, and then all I did, get a nice little stencil, like this, and I went ahead and stenciled farmers on it. Now, an issue is gonna be they're all very deep, and you don't wanna really damage that. So what I found that all you have to do is get a plastic container, a deli cup, a planter, find one that's gonna fit right inside without attaching it.
What a great little tip, I love that.
We're gonna add a nice little bow to the outside because, you know, I think hunker down on the sweet country aspect of it, a nice burlap bow in an accent color.
Make sure we can see that little
to match your, you know, to match your sort of flowers.
Very nice. I went out shopping. I got you something, Ken.
You were so kind in giving. You didn't have to.
You know.
And voila, there you have the wonderful sort of floor size vase.
Look how good that looks.
How easy.
That was like 42 seconds it took him to do that.
Pop that right there. Please come join me in the land of like
amazing.
Butter churn.
This is so nice, everybody. Ken.
Such part of North American history. I want everyone to celebrate them, find a way to work them into
their
homes.
Look, we've got a side table just to hold our little glasses of lemonade.
I'll be waiting for the birds to come.